I think that the word hope can be highly overrated. For example, all of us hope that we're going to get what we want and that we're going to avoid what we don't want. During the years that I ran a mind-body clinic, I met an awful lot of people whose hopes were dashed. They were young, had kids, and had cancer. Suddenly they found out their life was changed by AIDS. But I learned something quite amazing from these people. They would often say to me, "I never would have planned this. I never would have hoped for this. But this cancer, this illness, is the very best thing that ever happened to me because it opened up parts of my life. It taught me how to live in the moment. I realized that I had to give up hatred, that I learned how to forgive myself and other people. And I never would have learned those things without this experience." And so for me, I've replaced the word hope with the word trust, that we can trust life as it unfolds, because whatever it is that offers us, even the scary things that it offers us, are really things that we can hold on to in terms of learning to be more present to life, present to ourselves, and present to this moment. So we can't always hope, but we can count on trust. I'm Joan Borysenko.